everyone! I've been having fun experimenting with RPG Maker's eventing, seeing how far it can push its limits to create some mini-games. It's been an exciting challenge, and now I'm happy to finally share some of my attempts. I hope they inspire your own game projects too. If you need a smile today, I've got a silly blooper waiting for you at the end. Mini-games behind the scenes. I had to split this into three parts because turns out I had way too much to show in just one video. Everything you see here is controlled via events with no additional plugins used. I love creating mechanics like this because they push you as a developer to build everything by hand. Plus, don't you agree, a well-designed game mechanics or mini-game really adds an extra layer of depth to any game. This first part focuses on intense, reaction-based gameplay and features two mini-games, so let's check them out. This one started off as a joke. What if you were a tiny chicken desperately trying to escape a coop? Sounds simple, right? Nope! Every time you play, the exit is randomized and the other chickens aren't exactly friendly. They'll push you around, making escaping way harder than it looks. Mini-game breakdown. The escape door position is controlled by a variable that goes random from 1 to 10, meaning it has 10 possible door locations that change every round. If you look closely, I mark the possible door spots with beep, with scratch marks on the grass to give players a subtle hint. The game consists of 3 rounds, and every time you pass one, the other chicken's speed increases, blocking your way, making it even harder to get through. By the final round, it gets pretty intense. Oh, and I've added the timer here. You only have 40 seconds to reach the right spot, so no messing around. After beating all 3 rounds, you unlock a prize window where you can change the game's visual theme. So it basically changes seasons to winter or autumn, as well as the colors of the chicks. The autumn seems easier to play, while winter adds some difficulty since the scratch marks are a lot harder to see. As you can see, I had way too much fun coding this little mini-game. If you want to check it out, the link is in the description. So this one was actually a commission project. The goal was to create a simple shooting gallery inspired by Duck Hunt. The entire mechanic is event-driven and no plugins were used. Everything you see was done manually through event checks. As you can imagine, getting it right took a lot of trial and error, so I had to carefully think it through. Mini-game breakdown. I designed 6 lines of tiles with 3 dedicated to moving duck targets. The ducks move at different speeds, with faster ducks giving more points for any successful hit. It's interesting that everything is handled within a single map using eventing, variables, common events and switches to control all movements and mechanics. Instead of a traditional walking hero, the player character is now turned into a slingshot graphic, moving only left and right along a single line of map tiles. This system calculates projectile landings based on the hero and target positions, timing, and a few clever event tricks. It also features a timer, a game score, and consists of 3 different levels. For example, on level 1, there are only 3 targets, each moving at different speeds. Faster targets award more points, allowing you to score quicker. You need 100 points to progress to the next level. On level 2, additional 3 obstacles block in the way, and you must shoot them 3 times to break through before hitting the ducks. Then, on level 3, even the obstacles now move, making aiming much more challenging. Since RPG Maker doesn't have built-in hit detection for mechanics like this, I had to manually event projectile landings based on hero position, target movement, timing, and a few sneaky event tricks. It took some trial and error to make sure hitting the ducks felt right, but once we nailed it, the gameplay soon became super fun. If you'd like to try it out, the link is in the description. I hope you enjoyed this little showcase. Let me know which one you liked the most, and don't forget to stick around for part 2, where I'll be sharing even more cool mechanics. So this happened when I recorded the video. I marked the possible door spots with a huge truck. Oh, sorry, that's a plane.